Greenland, as you may know, is neither. Not green and not really land, but rather covered by the second largest body of ice in the world, second only to the Antarctic ice sheet. But the ice is melting fast.
The Greenland ice cap is now the largest contributor to global sea level rise. It's outstripped the general warming of the ocean, and it's contributing more than Antarctica does now.
The question is why? Because researchers say the increased melting cannot be explained solely by the global rise in air temperature. Larry Mayer is director of the Center for Coastal and Ocean Mapping at the University of New Hampshire and recently completed his 16th Arctic expedition.
Right now, the largest source of uncertainty in the models of the global sea level rise come from understanding what those melting processes are at the interface of the ice and the ocean.
A decade ago, scientists noticed something unusual at that interface in the fjords of northern Greenland. In some fjords, ice tongues like this were melting away, and in some places, they were growing.
This ice tongue was actually, over the last 70 years, moving forward.
Think of ice tongues as corks, which, once removed, allow glacial melt to flow freely into the ocean.
So why is one going away while one is growing?
A decade of study by dozens of scientists led to a working hypothesis, confirmed on Mayer's various trips to Greenland.
And what we found was that there was a cause other than the air temperature warming, and that was the fact that there's warm water. When we say warm, we mean over 0 degrees, that is circulating around the Arctic Ocean. It comes from the Atlantic. And if the, what we call the bathymetry, the shape of the seafloor, allows it, it will flow into the fjord and get under that ice tongue and start to break it up and melt it.
Mayer's team has been using remote vehicles equipped with wide-beam sonars to make detailed maps of the depths and contours of the fjords.
The multi-beam sonar has a swath, it's a fan-shaped swath, and it's typically 3 to 5 times the water depth.
They have found that fjords with deep channels that reach to the ice tongues funnel Atlantic water that increases melting. Shallow channels block the water and protect the ice tongues. So, could there be a fix, some way to limit the flow of warmer Atlantic water into the deeper fjords?
You think about the massive construction project that would be in an area so far removed. And it wouldn't stop global warming in any way, but it could slow the melting without question. And it would probably be billions to trillions of dollars. But think about the impact of global sea level rise. And if it buys us some time, there are people considering that.
During 2 decades of Arctic exploration, Mayer has seen the dramatic loss of sea ice. His expeditions now travel to places once inaccessible, places where no vessel has ever been. Amid the change and the concern, there is spectacular beauty, breathtaking vistas, and abundant wildlife. Polar bears, Arctic fox, a pod of narwhals. It was the Viking explorer Erik the Red who named it Greenland, an intentionally deceptive moniker in the hopes of drawing settlers to a more pleasant-sounding home. Now, scientists just hope the name isn't prophetic. A land of ice, melting away, increasingly exposed as green.
The Arctic is the canary in the coal mine for climate change, and particularly the sea ice and the melting of the ice. It just appalls me to think that anybody could think that things aren't changing rapidly and that we're having an impact on doing that.
And regarding the Atlantic seawater melting glacier, warm is a relative term. Larry says it's still way too cold to swim in.
It's only a degree or two above freezing, but that's enough to melt away at the glaciers, and that, as you heard, is contributing to sea level.